The Trade Department and social media giant TikTok look to strengthen their partnership to accelerate the country's e-commerce sector. DTI Secretary Alfredo Pascual says their collaboration with TikTok seeks to empower MSMEs and increase market access, particularly in rural areas, as outlined in the E-Commerce Philippines 2025 roadmap. Secretary Pascual also thanked TikTok for its swift action on concerns over the sale of vape products through its platform. TikTok has removed 570 user-generated content and 337 associated products to show its commitment to comply with local regulations. The Philippine government continues to distribute aid to communities severely affected by El Nino. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. gave out financial and livelihood assistance worth 60 million pesos to farmers and fisherfolk in Camarines Sur on Friday. Marcos also distributed over 1,000 land titles to agrarian reform beneficiaries.
Makakaasa po kayo na patuloy namin pangangalagaan ang kapakanan ng mga magsasaka, anumang balakid ang inyong harapin, dumating man ang tagtuyot o tagulan. Hindi rin namin lingid sa kaalaman ang problema na patuloy na sumusubok sa agricultural na sektor ng Camsur. Ang hinaharap natin ngayong El Nino. Hindi namin hahayaan na harapin ninyo ang nag-iisa ang mga hamon ng El Nino. Nandito kami para patuloy na umagapay sa inyo.
Over 80,000 families in Bicol were hit by El Nino. As of June 6, over 11,000 hectares of land in the region were affected by the dry spell, resulting in 500 million pesos in losses. Filipino farmers express fears of lower rice prices after the government's move to cut tariffs on imports of the staple grain. Jervis Manahan joins us on the line for more on that. Jervis, go ahead.
Yes, Denise, farmers are worried about the impending drop in tariffs for imported rice, which will make it easier for traders to bring in imported rice in the Philippines. This tariff cut is expected to reduce prevailing prices by around 6 pesos per kilo, which might also cause a drop in local prices. The farmers say they will suffer and they might get tired of planting. The National Food Authority said farmers won't need to worry because they will still buy unhusked rice or palay with their rate of 23 to 30 pesos per kilo. The NFA said the drop in tariff of imported rice has nothing to do with the buying price of NFA. And even if they bring the tariff to zero, the NFA will still buy at a price that will benefit farmers. The NFA also said they will not lower the buying price just because tariffs are also down, because their mandate is to buy from local farmers because they want them to continue planting and they want them to earn. The NFA also said they have bought a lot of palay from local farmers in the past month. In fact, they are nearing their target of palay buffer stock for the first half of the year. As of June 5, they already have 3.29 million bags of palay, which is already 98% of their target. This is a huge jump from the 145,000 bags of palay NFA had during the start of the year. NFA Administrator Larry Lacson said they only need to procure 72,000 bags more, which he said is very feasible. He said they are preparing for the upcoming La Nina and the calamities. He also said that a lot of their warehouses are full of palay right now, which serves as buffer stock of the country in case there would be emergencies and calamities. Denise.
Jervis Manan with that report. Thanks, Jervis.